Hey, it's Cruiser, where I show you how to make professional drone videos, and today I'm showing you what the S2 switch does on your Phantom 3. Check it out. Before we get into the video, I just want to say, if you want to learn how to make professional drone videos, make sure to go and subscribe to my channel and then hit that bell icon, and then you'll stay up to date to every video that I post on my channel. But let's just get into this. So if you see here, there's a couple different ways that you can flip this. And for the most part, when you fly, I'd recommend just leaving it in the middle. If your switch is left in the middle, for sure nothing's gonna happen. So if you're a beginner, you're not really sure what to do with this, you'll know after the video, but when flying, I always just leave it in the middle. Okay, so there's a couple different things you can do with this. The first is actually connecting your remote with your drone. And you would do this if, for example, something happened to your remote where it lost connection to your drone, or you got a new remote, maybe a used one from someone and your old one broke. You need to connect it though. So the way you would do this is you would hold down the dial here all the way down. Excuse me, I'm not sure like what the correct technical term is, but you would hold down the dial, and then as you're holding it down, you flip it up, down, up, down, up, down, and then you would do that until your remote starts beeping. When it starts beeping, that means you're ready to connect the remote with your drone. So then what you would do at that point is, you see here, you would lift up your drone, and then at the very bottom here, there's a little button, and I'll zoom in on that, but on this little button here, you'd get like a pencil, a toothpick, a small screwdriver, but you would pretty much insert that there, hold it for a couple seconds, and then while that's beeping, you would do that, and then it would connect and link up. So that's the first use case of what you would use the S2 switch for. And then the second use case is if you want to reset your Wi-Fi password. And the reason why you would want to do that is if you're like me and you forget what your Wi-Fi passwords are, you will need to reset it. So fear not, it's as simple as the other one. You just push the dial all the way up and then move it back and forth, up and down. You do about over 3 times, they say. And then eventually, you're gonna notice that the drone will start flashing green and red right here. And then you'll know that it's being reset. And then you'll go in your phone settings, and if you have an iPhone, you'd go into the where you'd connect to the internet, and then you would see a new name, like the factory, and then you'll see like the factory name for your drone. It'll probably say like Phantom 3, and then maybe like a couple of letters or numbers after that. You'd go into there, and then the default password, after you reset your password on the remote, is 1234, 1234. So you enter that in, and then you're connected to your drone and your remote, and then you're good to go on the app. Now, if you wanna go and reset your password on the app or change your Wi-Fi name on the app, then you would just go into the app settings, you'd click the 3 dots in the top right-hand corner, and then tap here, and then you'll see where you can change all that information. Wonderful. Now we're on the very last use case for the S2 switch, and that is for your return to home. As you know, you can return to home through your app on the phone, but let's say, for example, your phone runs out of battery and it dies while you're mid-flight. Fear not, you can still control the drone with your remote. And if you just want to return to home and you don't want to do a manual landing, you just go to the S2 switch, flip it up, down, 2 times. So up, down once, up, down twice. And at that point, it'll start beeping, and then you hear the normal return to home kind of sounds, and then your drone will start coming back. I use that if it's like an emergency, or if I kind of just want to have fun and practice using the S2 switch. I'll sometimes return to home using that. Comment below if you've ever had to use the S2 switch in resetting your Wi-Fi or landing your drone using it for return to home, and if you found it useful. And then make sure to subscribe to my channel if you want to learn how to make professional drone videos, and otherwise, keep cruising and see you in the next video.